Emotion V13. Oh, I'm so excited about this one and I can't wait to share with you the few things that I know or also the speculations that I think about this one. If you want to know everything about it, stay tuned until the end of the video. Hi everyone, Marcus here from EdTech, and if you love ESCs, PVs and everything that have an E of electricity, this is the place for you. And today we are going to talk about the Emotion V13 that, yes, I'm going to receive soon. I don't know the month that should be here. I have already covered also the Emotion V12 high torque that should arrive in the channel in about 2-3 months. When I'm recording this is basically past Christmas time, and there is something in there that I think that could be a very interesting feature. What is the information that I can share with you guys, or the information that I could put together? It's not coming two wheels. So there was some photos sharing that the V13 will come in suspension and without suspension. And no, it's just the suspension wheel, like they have announced. So it's just one wheel, it's not two wheels. But there is something behind that I think means, if you look to that photo, there is something hiding, but we'll talk about it. First of all, it's a 20-inch wheel. It's coming with a bigger tire, like a Sherman or like an EXN. So definitely a plus. It's going to be the biggest Emotion wheel. They say that is going to be the fastest electric unicycle on the market. So that is crazy. And they talk also that it's going to be the biggest range on Emotion. So definitely it's not going to be above 3,600 watt hours. I believe that is going to be between 2,700 and 3,200. It should be around those values. And maybe we have here something a little bit smaller that we'll talk in a minute. And when we talk about the suspension, I have here a suspension of the V11. I have shared on my Instagram, and if you don't follow me on the Instagram, there I always share my first thoughts when I'm testing out, just talking to you guys. So feel free to join me on Instagram. But when I shared that, I thought, I hope that this is not true. So I found a PDF with some information of the suspension, very similar to a suspension like you find on the S18, on the S20, even on the new Bigod wheels. But I really don't like that type of suspension. And if you think about it, when we talk about Emotion, it's mainly wheels to use in the city. So when they've done the V11, I use it off-road also, but this wheel was not thought to be used on off-road. When you look to the V11, or to the V12, this was not thought to use off-road. Now obviously it's coming the V12 high torque, and they are going to do it obviously for who wants to ride in off-road or in very bad situation, very bad conditions, floor. I have already covered that on the other video. Looking to the photos that we could see, I doubt that that suspension will be exposed on the back, on the inside. You could see from the side. I don't think so. So I think that they are going to use the same type of design that they have on the V11, but I hope that is going to copy the EX. The EX, if you follow me for a while, you know that is my favorite suspension. And why? Because it's the shorter one, and basically the pressure is made on the tire. So the readjustment is pushed on the tire. So if there is a hole, the tire is pushed down and is pushed up. When you are on the V11, is the rider that is pushed up. It's okay, but it's not the best suspension on the market. So I really hope that they will copy the EX, that is basically just putting upside down their suspension. So that is my hope about the V13. But I doubt that those drawings that I share with you guys on Instagram is the type of suspension that you'll find in there. If it will come a new V13 without suspension, will never come before the end of 2022. So don't expect that. So if you are between buying a V12 and you are not sure because it's coming a V13 without suspension, forget it, it's not coming. They have confirmed me that. And this is a massive butt, and obviously it's just me looking to that photo and doing some speculation. If you look to the photo carefully, you can see that it's a second wheel bigger, but it's exactly the same. When they was producing the V12, they was asking me in that time, and I have shared that on the prototype video, so it's nothing new that I'm sharing with you guys.
I said that I thought that the battery was a little bit too short on this one. They said it's not possible to put it more. I tried to ask them to deliver this wheel with basically 2000 watt hours, but they said that it's going to come supposedly an external battery that will be able to connect to this one.
They was asking me what was my thoughts about extra 800 watt hours battery that you could put on top of the wheel. So in opposite that the V12 was with 1,000 and 700 watt hours will be with 2500 watt hours. So I was quite excited with the idea, but that idea never came out. That's why I think that these pads here, they are removable on the V12. It was to basically set the extra battery on the top of this wheel. So looking to that photo, and you see that there is a bigger wheel on the back. One of the features that I believe is going to happen on the V13, like I said, is just speculation based on what they was asking me for the V12. Maybe we'll have a V13 that will have two different approaches, even if it's just one, that you can purchase without the extra package of battery and with that package. And you'll have two types of performance, maybe even higher performance when you put that extra battery and slightly slower when you don't have it. And obviously you are going to get more range. So in that way, Emotion, if they are able to do that with the V13, they will be able to kill two birds in one stone. I think it's like that you say in English. In Portuguese it's different. What I always felt is when it comes to weekends and I want to go out with my friends, 1700 is a bit short. But if I could have a bigger battery for the weekends, and during the week 1700 is more than enough because I normally do 24 miles, that would be like perfect. There is riders for sure that they live in an apartment and they don't have an elevator. Having that option to just take the battery out, having a lighter, man, it's so much potential on this idea that I'm really excited to see if they manage to do it to the V13 or not. Let me know if you think that this is stupid or if this makes sense. My name is Marco, this is MedPack. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, comment below, smash the thumbs up, do whatever you want, but always with a smile on your face. And I hope to see you in the next one.